Welcome back to Starfield, everybody. We're trying to figure our way out through this NASA compound. Blah. Oh, great. Fun! Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, use the link in the description for freecash.com. My brain. My brain's telling me yes, but my body's telling me no. I ain't gonna hurt nobody, but there's something I must confess. What should that be? Nope. Bugger. See, you can't. You cannot. How about this? How about your mother? It's a goose. This has to be this one. Oh, my brain. My goodness. Your mother's a goose. Aha! I turned the switch. Turret control? Wait, I don't care about such things. Okay, this garage door opened up. Was that noise? It's just stuff everywhere. Okay, this is some kind of device. What kind of crazy exploration is this? Trashed out building. It's like every environment we've been in. NASA Research Computer. National Aerodynamics and Space Administration. Security procedures. Check all badges. Yeah. Yes, even generals. No phones or recording devices.
Project log. Dr. Victor Issa. We turned on the prototype today. The gravitational field around it began to fold as we long suspected. Complete reversal of gravitational pull was observed on dozens of loose objects around the lab. I'm setting up a meeting with the directors to propose a larger test. The prototype proves we don't need the original anymore, but further work is going to have to take place in space. Somewhere with abundant helium-3 and with a civilian partner. Someone with access to large-scale manufacturing resources and computational equipment. Engineering gravitational folds pulling the far side of the solar system.
Project Log, Dr. Judith Petzian. I watched the gravjet test from the moon today. It was the first time we were able to talk to the team at Nova Galactic directly. So many things were under wraps before, but now everyone wants all the publicity they can get. I'm already seeing proposals for manufacturing androids of drives. Expeditions to Alpha Centauri and beyond. It's also overwhelming and worrying. It could take years, decades, before we know what all these side effects of operating a grav drive can be. But no one wants to hear that right now. Like a bunch of pioneers racing towards the edges of the frontier without knowing about the grizzly bears in the mountains.
Uh-huh. Hey, what's that? A gauge. Huh. What? Why is there no gravity there? Oh. I don't care about this room. There's a computer in there, though. Fine.
Oh, I can't auto.
Well, this is rough. This is gonna be rough. This is gonna be rough. No, you're gonna be something like this. Excuse me. Yes, it's still sick. Aha! And then bugger. I gotta solve this one first. Wait, I don't think I can. Nope. That's unsolvable. No, it isn't. Okay, it's solved. So it's not these ones. It's gotta be these guys somehow. My brain. It's not that one. It's not that one. In that location. It's not this one at all. No. It's probably you. Got it. Give me something great, no? Micro repellent. Hate you, game. There better be like thousands, billions of dollars in here. You're not usable. You are so usable to me. Can't you see? All bullets. Antique videotape. An AK-47. Alright. Fine. Why is there no gravity in this area? Ooh. Why is there no gravity in this area? That was a dead body. Why is there no gravity in this area? Explain it to me. Explore space helmet. Palm relay and sealant. I don't care about that stuff. Why? Oh, is it because of this? Is this thing operating? Oh yeah, I'm getting cancer right now. Floating everywhere. Oh, come on. Let me up. Let me down. Go. Full speed. Nope, that ain't right. Full speed again. What is all this ruckus? Okay, there's like a door here. Emergency access. Go. That's a pistol. Distilled water. This is here in the other one. Here. Buggered. That's pretty good. Pretty good. Fly, you fool. Oh, another dead body. That's a gunshot. Prototype drive. Be careful when running power through the prototype. Secure all loose objects, empty pockets, things float around. All right.
I never actually got to visit your labs back when we were working on the craft drive projects. Seems like ancient history now. Only thing we're doing these days is launching weather satellites. Guess this is as good a retirement as any. Now, Project Demeter, you want our help manufacturing scanners to better track these new meteorological patterns we've seen.
Our guess is that the poles might be naturally shifting, causing some gravitational fluctuations that are throwing off our old models.
Why do you need the scanning tolerances to be so small? What are you trying to find?
I just want to be sure. It's not like we're doing much these days anyway. The glory days are over. Why not give ourselves a challenge before they write us off in the history books?
Okay. Requested astrophysics research team has done full analysis data provided measurements of Earth magnetosphere shows clear signs of fluctuation, often in correlation with periods of frequent and large gravity wave spikes emanating from the moon. Gravity waves seem to be affecting the magnetic shield provided by the Earth's inner core may be affecting the core itself. As our magnetosphere falters, the ability to protect us from the sun's solar winds falters beyond the devastating effects of solar radiation. This will lead to something far more dire than sputtering or stripping away of our atmosphere. This has happened before to Mars. So, gravity from the moon is messing with Earth. Okay?
I know what I'm seeing, Victor. The data coming back from the satellites is very clear.
Uh-oh.
Drives be fixed. I'm working on some designs that should discreetly solve the problem under the guise of an emergency update to the fueling pumps.
We're talking about the end of Earth, and you're trying to be subtle about it.
Judith, the last thing we need is people losing faith in grav drive technology. That might be our only option.
To what? Are you seriously saying we should abandon Earth?
The timeline is under 50 years. A blink of an eye for a planet. But more than enough time for a human exodus.
And what do we tell people?
We say it's an act of God. One that science has found a solution for. Time for humanity to take its place in the stars. My name is Dr. Victor Issa. And if you're listening to this, then you probably already know the truth. I was young when I first headed the retrieval team of an odd gravitational anomaly on Mars. But I kept what really happened that day hidden from everyone except one other person. Even she didn't believe me at first. But I have no reason to lie to anyone now, so I hope you'll accept this confession. When I touched the anomaly, I experienced 12 days of lost time. I met myself. He told me everything that has since come true. The grav drive equations, the tests on the moon, Earth's atmosphere sputtering away because of what we had done. But he also told me about a city thriving on a planet orbiting a distant star. Human culture, art, music, lifestyles evolving and shining brightly across all of space. What price would I be willing to pay for that future? Maybe you don't believe me. Maybe Judith was right and I'm just a coward who wants to believe his mistakes were justified. But everyone has forgotten about the real origins of the grav drive, this artifact from Mars. I hope you make better use of it than I did.
Wow. Okay. Yeah, I ran the whole wrong way. Open. Wow. Artifact Psi.
Observation. We've arrived on the surface of Earth. We need to discuss what you found. And it looks like other Starborn got here before us. So, you might have company.
Oh boy. No, you don't. You think you're so good? Let me show you what my abilities are. Gravity field. Where's the shield? Yeah. Hey. Ah! I hit a chain. Where's it going? Oh! Why? Get away from me. How are you healing? Oh my goodness. That was terrifying. In shotguns we trust. All right. I see you. Reload. You'll never hit me. You hit me with magic. Right. What is that? I don't know. Oh, these Starborn bastards. What is that? Okay. We know it's garbage. can't fly anymore. So how do we get up? Don't exactly know. Yep, okay. Let me go this way. I'm gonna go up here. Reload. Much crap on me. Antique videotape. Fine, drop them. Distilled water. Get rid of all this fiber. This tank. This plunger. Okay, we're okay now. That was it. Oh, hello? That. Whoa! Stop it. Oh boy. Ow. I got a shield, boys. One dead. No. Holy Toledo. Okay. Reload all my guns. Ow. It's up. Power required. I think I got all those power cells. What's this? Something I don't want. That's a power cell. Might be required. Did you pick a maintenance key? Okay. I knocked over a bucket. Emergency cuttable wall. Oh, we gotta open this the hard way. I feel like that's correct. And that's correct. And, you and you? That was way harder than it should have been. There's... freaking out. Perfect. Ah! Who just shot me? Okay. Ow. Eclipse them. Where'd he go? Why only four bullets? There he goes. Okay. It's gonna be more. More Starborn. I'm lost. I am lost. I am so lost. Okay. What was that? I don't know. Let's go. Get out of here. There's more Starborn everywhere. In the shield we trust, though. Talk to the emissary. Alright, fine. What's up, boys? How's it going?
Do you understand now why I asked you to come here? The artifacts unlocked the secret of interstellar travel at the cost of Earth.
An easy trade, honestly. Why have one world when you can have all the settled systems?
We lost our home. I agree. Humanity's destiny was the stars.
Don't you see? The power of the artifact forced humanity to the stars. They didn't get to make a choice. How many would have chosen Earth? What gave Victor Issa the right to choose for them?
You see the hypocrisy in what the emissary is saying, right? The They don't want to rob people of their free will, but then they steal the artifacts for themselves.
In the wrong hands, the power of the artifacts can make anyone a tyrant. That is why we watch over them. The only thing you are watching out for is yourself.
Artifacts seem to be in the right hands. You're both wrong. It's time someone other than a Starborn made a decision.
Don't be a fool. The Emissary and I may have our differences, but you do not want to give us a common enemy.
For once, he is right. Don't do this. We can collect the final pieces together.
I'll get it on my own. Side with the Hunter. No, why would I side with the Hunter? He's just gonna betray me. And same with the Emissary. I don't trust either of you guys.
Well, look at that. The Emissary just became my new best friend.
You've made your choice. When you're ready, the Hunter and I will be at the buried temple. That's where we'll settle things.
Meaning, we'll kill you. But hey, at least we'll wait till you get there. Everyone deserves a shot at the final artifact.
Wow. That's a whole level. That's them. That's the Emissary, that's the other boy. My ship. I have no idea. It's all the way near this other side. Well, thanks for nothing, Sarah. It's probably my fault. I probably forgot to bring her on. Let's see how freaked out they get. I don't trust the Hunter because he seems too crazy. His philosophy is right. It's an all or nothing game, but in this case, I'm the all.
It's nice to see you.
Yes?
Where's Sarah?
Nice to see you.
This is my crew, but where's Sarah? Alright, let's sleep for an hour and see if I can get Sarah to come back. Excuse me.
Is mining on the schedule today?
No. I seem to have misplaced a Sarah. Okay. Sure. Let's go to the lodge and see if I can get Sarah back. I guess after the... Man. I think after the funeral, they all reset. And I had to go and tell one to be like my homie. Or it's when I reorganize my crew a little bit. Well... You know. Yeah, see? Nobody. So I'm assuming Sarah's gotta be in here, right? Sarah and Barrett? I agree.
Let's get a second opinion, shall we? Walter and I were just discussing the expenses incurred during the attack.
No, I was explaining that there's nothing to discuss. It's been taken care of.
It seems that Walter has taken it upon himself to cover the costs of the repairs to both the lodge and the Eye. As well as any expenses relating to the funeral services.
Sam was a good man. It's the least I could do.
Thanks, that was kind.
Well, it's not about looking for thanks. I just... it needed to be done, that's all.
Well, I can't thank you enough, Walter.
Sarah, I know we argue about money all the time. Most of it is in jest, but occasionally it's not. This is the one I can best contribute to our work. It has been, and continues to be, an honor to do so. And when this is all over, we can go back to squabbling about minor expenses. But it was important to me that I do this.
Fair enough. Well, since we're already talking about this, there is one more thing I'd like to do for Sam, and I'd like to get your opinion. Nothing extravagant. Just a small plaque here in the lodge. Something to remember them by. Where do you think would be appropriate?
Should be in the garden.
I hadn't thought of that. That's it. Any objections, Walter?
No. I think this is a fine idea.
Then it's settled. I'm glad we had this discussion.
And now, perhaps we can try and move on.
Yes. I think that's right. You've got something for me?
Ready to head back out?
I'm glad you're back.
Let's get moving. So, in between episodes, I'm going to try and build the ship so I can have more crew somehow. I don't know how we're going to do that, but I want all the crew. I want them all to be my friends. I got to go outside. We got to go to the spaceport. So I'll see you in the next episode. Let me monkey around with the crew. See if I can get... there's some calculation with the ship, but we'll see if we can do something. I might even build a full new ship, because we are flush with cash. Somehow I can see that. $536,000. Yeah, we're pretty good. We are pretty good. I'm just pushing the wrong button. All right, bye.